over rupees 3 lakh crores are spent in rural areas every year if we add all the programs meant for the rural poor by the central budget and the state budgets. Budget linkage for self-help groups. With a clear focus on improving accountability and outcomes and convergence, we will undertake a mission Antyodaya to bring 1 crore households out of poverty and make 50,000 gram panchayats poverty free by 2019, the 150th birth anniversary of Gandhiji. We will utilize the existing resources more effectively along with annual increases. This mission will work with a focused micro plan for sustainable livelihood for every deprived household. A composite index of poverty free gram panchayat would be developed to monitor the progress from the baseline. Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana is now being implemented as never before. The pace of construction of the PMGSY roads has accelerated to 133 kilometers road per day in 2016-17, as against an average of 73 kilometers per day during the period 2011-14. We have also taken the task of connecting habitations with more than 100 persons in the left-wing extremism-affected blocks. We have committed to complete the current target of PMGSY by 2019. I have provided 19,000 crores in 2017-18 for this scheme. Together with the contribution of the states, an amount of 27,000 crores will be spent on PMGSY in 2017-18. We propose to complete 1 crore houses by 2019 for the houseless and those living in kaccha houses. I have stepped up the allocation for the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen from rupees 15,000 crore last year to rupees 23,000 crore in the current next year. We are well on our way of achieving 100% village electrification by 1st May 2018. An increased allocation of rupees 4,814 crore has been proposed under the Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Gram Jyoti Yojana for 2017-18. I have also proposed to increase the allocation of the Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana National Rural Livelihood Mission for promotion of skill development and livelihood opportunities for our people in the rural areas to 4,500 in 2017-18. The allocation of the Prime Minister's employment generation and credit support schemes has been increased more than 3 times. The Swachh Bharat Mission has made tremendous progress for promoting safe sanitation and ending open defecation. Sanitation coverage in rural areas has gone up from 42% in October 2014 to about 60% now. 18% bada hai. Open defecation free villages are now being given priority for piped water supply. We propose to provide safe drinking water to cover 28,000 arsenic and fluoride affected habitations in the next 4 years. There will be a submission for the National Rural Drinking Program. For imparting new skills to people in the rural areas, mason training will be provided to 5 lakh persons by 2022, with immediate target of training of at least 20,000 persons by 2017-18. Panchayat Raj institutions still lack the human resources for implementing developmental programs. A program of human resource reforms for results will be launched in 2017-18 for this purpose. The government will continue to work closely with the farmers and the people in rural areas to improve the life and the environment. This is a non-negotiable agenda for our government. The total allocation for rural, agricultural and allied sectors for 2017-18 is a record 1,87,223 crores, which is 24% higher than the last year.